Thank you. guys, so that was the training routine, and I quickly wanted to mention as well what kind of supplements I take during the day, because that is actually a very frequently asked question. However, I've actually never really answered this on my Instagram or here on YouTube, but you probably already can tell what kind of supplements I take, because most of them I show them on my stories on Instagram, if you follow me, of course. However, let's dive deep into what I take, and before I show you what kind of supplements I take, I first and foremost want to say that supplements are there to supplement your diet. Supplements are not magic. I think that's a really important thing to remember. Like, it's not that if you take a protein shake, for example, that you're gonna have massive legs without putting in the effort with your training and having a structured and clean diet. Supplements are there to supplement your diet and your lifestyle, but it can only work and it can only be beneficial for you if the other two parts, nutrition and training, are also on point. Otherwise, you're just wasting your time, you know. So I think that's one of the most important things that you should always remember. And then second, what kind of supplements you need depends on your diet, what kind of training you do, like for example powerlifting, or you're more into bodybuilding, or you're more into triathlon. I don't know, it all depends on what kind of supplements your body will need. And yeah, the stricter your diet, the more clean you eat, the less you will actually need. So if your diet is like really bad, then obviously you will need more supplements to, you know, keep like a kind of good balance, you know. So yeah, that's the thing. Also, I've never really been a fan of taking and this, and that, and that, and this, and this. You know, there is so much information out there. There's so much, actually, also out there. Like, you really have to be very selective in what kind of things you want to take. Because if you just believe the internet and you believe everything that you get advertised. Like for example, those gummies for the hair, or gummies for fat loss, or whatever it is. It's just sad, because I know a lot of people still believe in that kind of things. But I guess that's just a lack of knowledge. So yeah, less is more, always. So I think this is the thing that you have seen coming by on my Instagram almost daily. It's OxyShred by EHP Labs. Now this is in the flavor Cosmic Blast, and it's the Ultra Concentration. This is a pre-workout. Now, I've actually never really been a huge fan of pre-workouts because they usually get me very nauseous. And yeah, I just don't like that, you know? But the positive thing with OxyShred is that I have never experienced a nauseous feeling when taking this. Also, because it's not like a very big, how do I need to say it, like a very brutal, intense pre-workout. Because the one thing that is not in OxyShred is beta-alanine, if I say that correctly. That's the acid, I don't know the correct word, but like the thing that gives you that itchy feeling. Hate it, hate it. I really don't like it, and luckily this is not in OxyShred, so this makes it a very light and natural boost of energy. If I just want some extra energy, I would just take two scoops instead of one. Also, another great benefit is that it suppresses your appetite, so perfect to take for example in the morning when you want to do some cardio before your breakfast, but you wake up with a hunger feeling. Take some OxyShred, your hunger feeling will fade away, you will survive your cardio session without any problem. So yeah, that's something that I really, really like about Toxischwit. Yeah, if you're in a fatless phase and your goal is obviously to get leaner, to lose fat mass, this can really help because it also reduces cravings and, as I said, it suppresses your appetite, so you will more likely will stick better to your diet, as you will not experience those crazy craving feelings. Well, that was a lot of crazy. So yeah, that was number one. Then number two is Blessed Protein, also by EHP Labs. This is in, so far, my favorite flavor, and it's a strawberry milk. Now, this is a vegan protein. It's soy-free, it's gluten-free, it's dairy-free, so it's 100% vegan. It doesn't contain any artificial sweeteners. It's sweetened with 100% stevia, so that's a good thing. And if you wonder what it is made of, it's made of pure golden pea protein. Also, number one question I always get when I show you guys less protein on my stories is, does it get you bloated? Because actually a lot of vegan proteins tend to get you very bloated and also taste very awful. No, been there, done that before I partnered up with EHP Labs. I also used some vegan protein from other brands and it was just horrible, you know. Not saying this because I work with EHP Labs, I'm always very transparent. If I don't like anything, I will just say it. I will just not drink a protein shake every day if I don't like it and if I almost have to puke from it, you know. So it doesn't really make sense. So yes, taste is very nice, it's super creamy, even if you drink it with water. I switch now and then, usually I drink it with water or unsweetened almond milk. And then, does it get you bloated? So far, I haven't experienced any bloating after drinking my Blessed Protein shake. Now, yeah, I wouldn't 100% like say you will definitely not experience any bloating because, you know, everybody is different. I would just say if you're looking for a good vegan protein shake and you haven't had any good experience so far, give it a try and please let me know what you think of it. We have already come to the final and third supplements I take. As I said, I don't take a bunch of supplements because my diet is actually, I'm not saying that I'm eating super, super, super clean like I would do for a competition. I'm definitely not doing this at this point, but let's say I'm eating for 80% healthy and nutritious meals during the day, and then 20%, you know, my piece of chocolate. I eat a daily piece of chocolate, you know. I'm a woman. I don't know if that's like for every woman, but yeah, I just need a piece of chocolate every day. However, let's stop rambling and go to the third supplement, and that is magnesium. Magnesium. This is the liquid version. Now, the reason why I go for a liquid version is because it absorbs better into your system than when you take it in like a capsule form. So if you want to take magnesium, always go for liquid form. It's just better. And then the reason why I take some extra magnesium, I take just one tablespoon per day during my lunch. It helps with fatigue. No, especially when it was winter over here, you know, the days are like very short, it's very quickly dark outside, you know, and I usually have a lot of, you know, I feel a lot of problems with this, you know, to keep on going to get my day started. Even if I slept 8-9 hours, I'm still super tired, so this definitely helps, and I just take it all year round. It doesn't matter if spring and summer is now coming, I just take it all year round. It's also very good for bone health, heart health, heart diseases, and it's also good for an optimal muscle function, so it reduces also muscle soreness. And yeah, those are basically like the reasons why I take some extra magnesium. You can also find it in avocados, pumpkin seeds, nuts, in salmon. So yeah, if you have a diet very rich in those kinds of foods, you probably won't need any extra magnesium, But yeah, I don't like salmon. I sometimes eat avocados, but not like every day. I don't eat every day nuts. So yeah, for me, you know, as I said, it really depends from person to person. So in my case, it's optimal to take some extra magnesium to hit my daily goal. So yeah, that's basically it, guys. I truly hope you enjoyed watching this video. As always, give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful or inspirational. I don't know what you think of it. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and see you next time. Bye.